It could be argued that everyone has a black sheep in the family. If you don't think yours does, then it's probably you. And this is still the case, even if you are the most famous family dynasty in the world of popular music. For a time period at least, if one name was uttered to any member of the Jackson family, the words, "What now?" would evidently follow. That name being LaToya. LaToya Jackson's life by the early 1990s couldn't have been more different than just a few years earlier. From feeling entrapped living at home firmly under the thumb of her domineering father, to fleeing to New York City with the promise of a new life under the guidance of her new manager, Jack Gordon. However, it wasn't long until the same patterns began to reemerge once again. Manipulation, abuse, and acute desperation seemingly followed LaToya no matter what circumstances she found herself in. This time, however, LaToya fell into a self-imposed isolation, away from her superstar family. But if she felt like the outcast, things were about to get a whole lot worse. When her relationship with Michael, an ally she always felt understood her methods and internal struggle, wasn't just about to be fractured, but completely shattered entirely. Here's the detail. History repeated. At the beginning of 1993, the disparity between the lives of LaToya and her brother Michael couldn't have been further apart. The King of Pop had just returned from the first leg of his Dangerous World Tour, and he would soon be preparing to headline at the Super Bowl halftime show, a performance that would become a groundbreaking moment in American entertainment. Meanwhile, LaToya began the year grappling a serious lawsuit with the Las Vegas show, Bare Essence, a production she was scheduled to perform at. Due to receive a fee of $26,000 a week, LaToya, once again, gave notice and walked out of the show, causing the production company to sue her for failing to complete her contract. With family tensions at an all-time high, and despite having not seen several members of the Jackson clan for years at this point, LaToya was eager to meet up with her sister Janet when they crossed paths in Minneapolis. The middle sister was in town filming for her exotic club tour video, and during a break in recording, traveled to Janet, who was in the studio preparing for her next LP. However, a scuffle broke out between the two sisters, and in the press, the reason for the altercation was at first quite vague. Quote, LaToya said something Janet took exception to. Janet struck LaToya. They both yelled for their bodyguards. However, the truth according to LaToya seems to be centered around a grave misunderstanding. She claims that after her microphone pack was disconnected after filming, she then rushed to the studio to see her sister, while still wearing the microphone itself. Upon seeing the microphone, Janet told LaToya to get away from her, accusing her of recording their conversation. A justifiable assumption, as in recent years, LaToya had become a reliable source for salacious stories relating to her family, triggered by the allegations and revelations she presented in her tell-all autobiography. So, Janet's reaction may have been prompted by fear that her older sister, likely organized by Jack Gordon, was in fact secretly recording her in order to catch her off guard. This would be the last occasion in which the two sisters would communicate for some time, resulting in another sour end to what was previously a strong family tie. Just as LaToya's connection with key members of her family seemed to fall apart, so did the intensity of physical and mental abuse she experienced at the hands of Jack Gordon. The man who LaToya once trusted and found her emancipation from her father Joseph with was now becoming an even worse dictator that ruled over her life in every aspect imaginable. Its severity was truly felt when LaToya almost lost her life to the hands of Jack's violent tendencies. At their home in New York, Gordon repeatedly beat the starlet with a brass dining chair, leaving LaToya knocked out cold, with black eyes, a swollen lip and chin, various bruises across her body, and cuts that would require stitches. As a result, Jack was duly arrested, and for a brief moment, LaToya could have finally broken away from her legal husband-turned-manager. But unfortunately for her, Jack was eventually released, citing he reacted in self-defense. LaToya would even go on to publicly defend Gordon, stating that she forgave him for his violent actions, blaming the incident on drugs he was taking as part of his radiation treatment for cancer. With LaToya firmly at his defense, Jack Gordon was as brazen as ever concerning his violent behavior towards his wife and client, essentially admitting on Howard Stern that he had been physically abusive to LaToya live on radio, resulting in an aghast and awkward reaction from Howard Stern and others.
She just said he gets physical.
Right.
Now you're telling us that he has pushed you around or hit you on a number of occasions?
Jack, you better cut that out.
What is
that
wrong
is totally
with you?
Not, wait a minute, that's totally
no,
not true.
No, he said he would never give that me a not, divorce. No, no. Never, ever.
But, he hasn't beaten you on numerous occasions.
Oh, boy, Jack.
Not true.
He has?
Not true.
You two have a difference of opinion here.
Man.
Jack, you better stop getting physical with LaToya, or else I'll have to kick your ass.
With LaToya now firmly under Jack Gordon's control and her professional career at his mercy, Gordon kept the starlet working no matter what. Despite dwindling opportunities in show business, LaToya therefore found herself involved in increasingly seedy and lowbrow projects in order to cash in on her family ties and bizarre sexpot public image. However, no matter what depths Jack was willing to take LaToya's career, an incoming bombshell was about to detonate across the entire Jackson family, with the epicenter being focused on their golden goose, Michael. Will you be there? In late August 1993, news broke that Michael Jackson had been accused by a 13-year-old boy of sexual molestation. As this revelation spread across news outlets around the globe, several members of the Jackson family swiftly spoke out against the allegations and stood as a solid wall of defense for the superstar. Not one not to pass comment on scandals relating to her family, LaToya appeared in the press in early September, seemingly in support of her brother, stating, quote, "If you really think about it, he's been convicted before a trial." However, within the same article, she also made comments that come across as a lot more ambiguous, particularly regarding whether she suspected Michael had committed the crimes he was being accused of. Quote, "I honestly don't think he'd do anything like that, but we don't know." Regardless of having received the cold shoulder from the majority of her family, LaToya was still holding out for her once best friend, despite outside pressures for her to change her tune. With 1993 drawing to a close, the speculations surrounding Michael Jackson weren't going anywhere. In fact, it was increasing at an alarming rate. After his dangerous tour was brought to an early conclusion, Michael himself was completely depleted physically and mentally, entering rehab for treatment for a dependency on painkiller medication. With the investigation heating up and a potential court date looming, speculation was rife in the press. Many came out publicly to share their experiences with the superstar, with tabloids paying huge ransoms for increasingly incriminating and salacious gossip relating to Michael's sexual exploits. Despite this, the Jackson family continued to fiercely back Michael's corner. However, there was one cog in the machine that was about to break loose, and for Michael, perhaps not the one he would have expected. Anything for money. Sensing an opportunity to make money off this intensifying scandal, Jack Gordon moved fast, stating that LaToya would offer up revelatory details on both Michael's conduct as well as further family secrets in exchange for large sums of money. $50,000? That'll buy you secrets on family abuse she and others suffered as children. $100,000? You'll get double the amount of detail, and for the paltry sum of $500,000, she would provide proof to support the allegations and her own statement that she now believed her brother Michael was a pedophile. Whilst initially a bidding war escalated between US and UK-based tabloids, no financial deal ever came to fruition, as the bidders sensed that there wasn't much substance beyond LaToya's promises of information, ultimately leading Jack orchestrating a Tel Aviv press conference as a last resort. On December 8, 1993, LaToya stood before cameras and delivered a statement that was a complete U-turn from what she previously said a few months earlier. The middle sister now proclaimed that she could, quote, not be a silent collaborator of his crimes against small innocent children. Her statement continued to deliver blow after blow against her younger brother. Quote, "Forget about the superstar. Forget about the icon. If he was any other man who was sleeping with little boys, you wouldn't like this guy." With such a close member of his family standing up publicly against Michael, this was all many needed to believe the alleged claims that have been made. Naturally, other members of the Jackson family actively spoke out against LaToya's new stance and scathing statement, with Brother Jermaine stating that, quote, "There is no validity to what she is saying. She knows that she is Michael Jackson's sister and that people will listen." Other members of the Jackson clan weren't off the hook either, with LaToya stating that her mother Catherine, quote, "had frequently complained that Michael was homosexual and had shown her checks made out to his alleged victim's parents." Catherine, incensed by these comments, rebutted her daughter's damaging claims. Quote, "I can't believe I have a daughter out there saying these things to sell her brother down the river." One of Michael's legal defense, controversial lawyer Johnny Cochran, said of LaToya, quote, "This appears to be a member of the Jackson family who has decided to use that relationship to make consistently outrageous and false statements in order to generate some notoriety for herself." In some ways, comments like this were a vicious circle for LaToya. She'd gone from residing in the shadows of her more successful siblings to now weaponizing them for her own gain, becoming what would be branded by Michael Jackson himself, a tabloid junkie. Jack Gordon also couldn't help but throw his two cents into the mix, adding that Michael had, quote, "threatened to kill her and tried to kidnap her twice to keep her from revealing his secrets." This statement would turn out to be bitterly ironic, as it was Gordon's own threats and aggressive outbursts that directly forced LaToya into giving this incriminating statement in the first place. Several years later, LaToya would claim that Jack had not only threatened her, as he was doing on an alarmingly regular basis, but also the lives of her siblings. Quote, "If you don't do this, I'm going to kill your brother, Michael, and I'm going to kill your sister, Janet." She recounted, "Having been embroiled in a world of fear cultivated by Jack for the past few years, LaToya soon felt she had little choice but to agree. In fear now not only of her own life, but also her estranged siblings were now at stake too." With increased press attention and offers from media outlets all over the world, LaToya was due to repeat her claims under a lie detector test for a Spanish program, The Truth Machine. Also present at this recording would be Michael's biographer, J. Randy Tarabarelli, who would be discussing the allegations with LaToya before a television audience, who would be left to judge whether LaToya's claims as truth or lies. However, on the day of recording, Michael would give his own statement from his home at the Neverland Ranch. In an emotional 4 minutes, he maintained his innocence, whilst also deriding the media for their manipulation of events, as well as reflecting on the humiliating ordeal he experienced during a full-body examination and photographing of his body. As LaToya watched this statement mere hours before taping of The Truth Machine was due to begin, it seems something was triggered within her, that the public facade she had to create due to Jack Gordon's ongoing threats had uncontrollably broken. Tarabarelli recounting that, quote, "Tears sprung from her large, expressive eyes. She seemed lost in thought until Jack Gordon burst into the room." Reportedly, after Michael's statement, Jack wanted LaToya's fee for appearing on the show doubled from $50,000 to $100,000. After the producers had told him to essentially go to hell in a fit of rage, Jack grabbed LaToya and stormed out. Her appearance on the show was now completely off the table, giving some insight into how Gordon conducted business and why LaToya was in such legal hot water with former clients. As she was accosted by her husband, Tarabarelli recalls that in desperation, the Jacksons said to him, quote, "You must think I'm a terrible person now, but really I'm not. Tell Michael I'm sorry." Despite LaToya's inner turmoil, she was reportedly forced into making large sums of money from the developing scandal, sharing details in newspaper interviews as well as on television and radio. LaToya's level of exposure was at an all-time high. For anyone in the entertainment business, this normally is a sign of success. However, LaToya once again found the content of her appearances centered around Michael, however this time, on the alleged accusations. Scandal after scandal, revelation after revelation, teasing the public with some new piece of proof or a bizarrely coded statement. Making regular appearances in the media, industry insiders, and the general public were starting to treat LaToya's words less and less seriously, becoming more like one big joke, leeching off her siblings' success or scandal to further her own profile. Little did many know that Jack Gordon was the puppet master pulling LaToya's strings. But after living a life married by abuse, both physical and mental, LaToya, by this point, seemingly had little fight left within her. The determined woman, desperate to break free from her family trappings in Los Angeles, was now a distant memory. LaToya once again found herself trapped, unable to break free, and at the complete command of her husband, whose violence and demands were escalating on a near daily basis. Something had to give, and for the next chapter, LaToya would utilize her celebrity to switch focus from her family and show the public just what kind of man Jack Gordon really was. Keep an eye out for part 5 as we explore the aftermath of the 1993 allegations and the consequences LaToya would face from her family as her toxic relationship with Jack Gordon would continue to torment her, What action would it take for LaToya to finally flee her abuser? Thanks for watching The Detail. We'll see you next time.